One of my favorite scenes in the book was the moment that Jacob reveals that he has imprinted on her daughter.
Let's face it, this was maybe the most controversial idea of this novel. So now here's the moment where it's confronted.
In action!
You imprinted on my daughter?
It wasn't my choice.
She's a baby!
It's not like that. You think Edward would have let me live if it was?
I'm still debating it.
I really love the way that Kristen plays it completely seriously, and she carries the weight of a mother protecting her child.
I've held her once! Once, Jacob! And you think already that you have some sort of moronic, wolfy claim on her? She's mine!
Good!
It was really funny, first of all, to watch Kristen get furious with Taylor, because they're like, you know, besties in real life. They get along really well. And so to see her, like, be furious, we don't get to see her furious a lot.
Jacob comes up with the bright idea of nicknaming Renesmee Nessie.
You nicknamed my daughter after the Loch Ness Monster?
It came from a very instinctive, protective, maternal, something that I've never experienced, but I can feel it. Just having toyed around with being really feral and crazy and aggressive and just takes it to a whole new level.
Bella really has this reaction that probably the audience has as well. Like, what? Are you kidding? And she beats the piss out of him.
She beats me up pretty good. She literally tosses me around the whole yard.
It was fun to throw Taylor around because Taylor's not only the best at getting thrown around, so I wasn't scared of hurting him, but it definitely makes you feel very empowered when you go like this and he flies across a forest.
Cut.
Just to know that the one newborn, you're the strongest, it definitely had an effect on, like, how I stand next to these big, huge guys that are clearly stronger than me.
Look, nothing ever made sense before. You, me, any of it. And now I understand why. This was the reason.
Okay, fine, but you guys are never sleeping in the same room, like, f***ing ever.
Good.
What else are we
going to
do?
Set. In action.
Don't hurt yourself, Emmett.
Kristen did such a good job of creating this entirely new character that feels like a new person. I was so impressed with her.
I win.
Also, we work to bring as much of her to it as possible. For example, you know, when she has that arm wrestling scene with Emmett, you know, there's this stuff she does after she wins and breaks the rock where she says, did you see that? You know, it's pure Kristen, you know? And I left it in just to make sure that it wasn't so different from the part that she created and from her.
In action!
Whoa, did you see that?
Sorry, Emmett. Guess you're not the strongest vampire in the family anymore.
So good. Okay.
Kristen has attacked the final two films with relish. She has really been enthusiastic in every regard with her excitement about finally playing a vampire and what that look was going to be and working with her hair and makeup people to create something that really she was confident in.
We did a lot of testing in what she was going to look like as a vampire. You know, we had variations with hair down to her knees. That seemed to be too much, but her hair is fuller. So it's that. It's obviously the typical makeup. But a lot of it had to do with costume. Suddenly, this girl isn't so geeky anymore, you know? I mean, it's not sort of hoodies and jeans. It's really leather, and it's a lot of black, and it's form-fitting, and it's height. We always had her in 4-inch heels so that she sort of in stature was closer to Rob.
Well, from the very first fitting with Kristen, she was tremendously excited about, you know, what is this vampire look going to look like for Bella? It was clear that it was going to be a very confident look for her and increasingly confident as she sort of gets to know what it is to be a vampire. So with the silhouettes of her clothes, we knew that we wanted it to be much closer to the body than the old pre-vampire Bella. When you think of, like, the first Bella that we meet, she's kind of hiding in her clothes, you know? She's in boyish flannel shirts, bootcut jeans and sneakers and stuff. And to see her go from that to this amazing, almost feline silhouettes of, like, tight leggings, t-shirt dresses, nice open neckline. things that really showed off her amazing shoulders and commanding physicality.
But it also was something that Kristen then played. It was just the way of holding herself. She was straight now, you know? I mean, whatever kind of slouchy alt thing that she was doing before, that's all gone. So it all combines to create a really different image.
When I was writing the books, that's how it felt, like Bella was coming into her own. She's more comfortable with herself there, and that was kind of a fun thing to write. There was that moment where she really feels like, I was born for this. I was meant to be this person. I have realized my potential.
My time as a human was over, but I never felt more alive. I was born to be a vampire.